अवेल सर्विस, टू अवेल सर्विस ऑफर्ड बाय द, अवेल सर्विस ऑफर्ड बाय द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. Offered by the organization. The basic objective is, the basic objective is to acquire information, is to acquire information then write down sales letter, sales letter. It is a type of letter, it is a type of letter which is written in order to persuade the reader, in order to persuade the reader to purchase a particular product, to purchase a particular product or service in written form. The basic objective is The basic objective is
can you please tell the spelling?
Endorsing.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Endorsing a concept. Then next one, placing an order. It is a type of letter. It is a type of letter which is written in order to provide requisition requisition, requisition, in order to give requisition.
MCQ.
REQ, sorry, requisition, requisition. In order to provide requisition of a product requesting its details. requesting its details. The basic objective is, the basic objective is to get the best thing at the best price. To get the best thing at the best price. Okay. Now come to the components of the letter. Components of the business letter.
Ma'am, what was the name of the last letter?
Placing an order.
Okay.
Placing an order. Okay. So we did inquiry letter, sales letter, placing an order, and complaint letter. We did it in the lab. Yes, anyone? You want? Anish wanted.
Yes, ma'am. In the previous class, you have discussed the components of letter, and so you have dictated it, like
I
the letterhead.
No?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Letterhead,
okay.
Sender's address, date, receiver's
okay.
name.
Oh my God, I had forgotten that. So now we'll start with the next chapter. That is business report. Okay, so what is the report? I'll just tell you. Then what are the types of report? So the topics which we will discuss is, I'll just show you what are the topics that we're going to discuss in report writing. Yes, definition we will discuss, components we will discuss. These are the notes that I will give, don't worry. Then what are the types, and then the components of the manuscript report. So you don't have to write anything. You can just listen to me, and I'm not going to give you the dictation, because these are the notes that I have prepared, and it is easy, it will be easy for you. Okay, so what is a report? Report is basically a form of written communication. Written communication which gives a detailed description about something or narrate an incident. Okay, normally what happens whenever you are asked to write something in detailed format about an incident. You are an employee of your organization, and suddenly there is an outbreak of fire in the campus, and you are asked to submit a report on the outbreak of fire. So what will you do? Obviously, you will visit the site. Then you will talk to the people, the eyewitnesses, and how this happened, and why did this happen, and other things. So this is these are the things that you will write, and finally you will give the conclusion. Thus, it is concluded that first you will write that on the basis of, why are you writing this report? On the basis of the meeting that was held by the committee members, a team was formed comprising of this, and. Which was asked to look into the outbreak of fire that took place on such and such date. Then action taken, interview with the eyewitnesses. So you will give a detailed report. Then finally, you will write the conclusion. Therefore, it was concluded that the outbreak of fire was caused due to the following reasons, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then steps taken for improvisation. Such steps could be taken for avoiding such things in future, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and then you will put your signature. So this is report, okay. But then there are other types of report also. So that we will discuss. So basically report is something which is given in the detailed form, right? So this is the meaning of report. Now, what are the types of report? There are various types of report which are very important from exam point of view. The first one is voluntary and authorized report. Voluntary report is that type of report which is written on your own initiative, on the writer's initiative. Now, for example, you might have seen in newspapers, I don't know whether nowadays anyone is going through newspapers or not, but then if you in newspapers, there will be some report that is written on, like, for example, there is the dogs are creating nuisance, and people, they write a report on the incidents and requesting the people and requesting action from the government. Okay, so this is an example which you write on your own. No one is asking you to write the report. You will write it on your own. So that is an example of voluntary report. Then the next one is authorized report. Authorized is you are writing a report on behalf of the organization. The organization has authorized you to write the report, so you are writing the report. Now, for example, you are, as I said, that the outbreak of fire on the basis of a committee meeting that was held by the managing director and other people, they have asked you to write the report. So you are submitting the report. You are submitting the annual report of your organization, of your department, to your authority. That is again an example of authorized report. So what you will do is you will write the definition along with one example. I think it's there in my notes. You will follow that, how you will write that. Okay. Then the next one is periodic and special report. Okay, so what is a periodic report? Periodic report is that type of report which occurs on regular basis. It could be for on a, it, it could be on monthly basis, it could be on daily basis, it could be on annual basis. Now, for example, you might have seen journals, journals. You can just Google it, or you might have seen magazines. They all they all come every fortnight. They all come every they come every year. They are based on the issues. So that is an example of periodic reports. And then special report it happens on one time basis. Now, for example, there has been a robbery in someone's place, and the person goes and lodge FIR, first information report. So that is an example of special report. Then the next one is short report. Short report is a type of report which is between 1 to 10 pages. Okay, so when you are writing any report that is between 1 to 10 pages is an example of short report. And memo will come under that. And then there are some reports which are written in letter format. So that is also an example of report. I'll just show you the sample and format. In the exam, the questions could be asked, write a report in memo format or write a report in letter format. And if nothing is given, you can write in any format you want. So that is a short report. Long report is which consists of more than 10 pages, those manuscripts. Like, for example, the books that you have, that you see, that is also a type of report. And then you might have seen that people are, the charge sheet when they are filing, they are submitting report of 120 pages, 500 pages. So these all are examples of long reports. But basically, manuscripts are examples of long reports. Okay, and we will do manuscript in details. Then the next one is internal and external report. Internal report is that type of report which is written between the employees who are inside the organization. We discussed one example, that is memo. So memo is an example of internal reports. External report is written for the outside use of the organization, to employees who are outside the organization. Now, for example, you hire an agency to write report for you. So again, that is an example of external reports. Then the last and the most important one, that is this one. Informational and analytical report. So every time it comes in the exam, okay. I don't know whether this time it will come or not, but every time it comes. That is, informational report is that type of report which is based on the information only. It doesn't have any conclusion. It does not have any recommendation or steps taken for improvisation. Like, for example, you might have seen weather report. They only give you the weather details of a particular place. Your progress report, whatever grade you get in different subjects, that is given instead of any recommendations or conclusions or anything. Okay, so this is an example. And analytical report is that type of report which not only gives information but also gives analysis of it. Gives conclusion, analysis, and also steps taken for improvisation. I give the example, when you write a report about the outbreak of fire or about the food that is available in the canteen or about the corona outbreak and the medical facilities. So these all are examples of analytical report. Okay, so these are the types of report. Anyone who has got any doubt? Okay, now the next one is we'll discuss the format of the report. So I'll just share the screen with you. Okay, so letter memo format, I think we have done it in our lab. I'll just show you the letter format. Okay, letter is this one, letterhead. As I said, you will write letter in your letterhead. And then next one is the date. You will write the date, then receiver's name and address, salutation, no need of writing any subject line as we write in letter. Then this is then directly you will come to the point, then subheadings and other things will be there, complimentary closure and signature, no copy notation, nothing. Okay, so this is an example. I'll just let me check if I have a sample. Let me just sample of report. Yeah, it's there. This is letter writing. Sorry. No, I'm not having this. But I'll check it if. It's there. No, this is not there. Okay, I'll just show it to you. Maybe in the next class I'll just show it to you. But as of now, I'm not getting that. Is this not this one? I guess. No, not this one. Okay, anyways, so let us move on to the next topic. That is, sorry. Shoot. Okay, so now we will discuss the components of the long report. Okay, so what is the long report that I discussed with you? Letters and short report is a type of report which is less than 1 to 10 pages, and it is memo is a type of I'm stopping the screen sharing. Memo is a type of short report, and it is used for the internal use of the organization, so it is a type of internal report. Now we will discuss the this long report, that is manuscript. Now, what is a manuscript form of report? Manuscript form of report is it is a type of long report which consists of more than 10 pages. It could be, as I said, 100 to 200. It doesn't have any limit, page limit. Okay. And whenever you are writing any research research project or research report or something, so that again is an example of long report. The book, the textbooks, that is also an example of long report. So based on that, we will discuss the components. The components are, I'll just show you again. Yeah, the components are first is cover. It consists of three parts actually. The first one is head, then the second one is body, and the third one is tail. So under head, it comes cover, title page, table of contents, and executive summary. So what is a cover? Cover consists of a soft or even hardbound cover which encloses the report, and its function is to protect the report from getting damaged. In maybe in your book, you might have seen the two either softbound cover or in fact hardbound cover. So that is the cover that always protects the report from getting damaged. The title consists of the title of the report and the affiliation of the author of the report. You will write the topic, what is the topic of the report or the title, and then the affiliation. Say for example, Anish has written the report, so he will write Anish Singh, Department of Computer Science, roll number this. Okay, and KIT University, obviously. So this is what you will write. Then the next one is table of contents. Table of contents, it is not optional depending on the report, because okay, fine. Suppose say for example, it is just 11 pages or something, and you don't have chapters, then you can say that it can be optional. But most of the time, it is compulsory. It consists of the topics that are to be discussed along with the page number, and so its benefit is to locate the topic immediately by the reader. It becomes easy for the reader to understand that. Then the next one is executive summary. It consists of the summarized version of the report. You may say that it consists of the one third of the report. So it gives an idea about the contents of the report. That is the meaning of executive summary. So executive summary explains why you wrote the report, emphasizes on your conclusions or recommendations, and includes only the essential or significant information to support these conclusions. Okay, then executive summaries are usually organized according to the sequence of information present in the full report. So follow the order of your full report as you discuss the reasons of your conclusions. Then executive summaries, they are also proportional in length to the larger work they summarize, typically 10 to 15%. Most executive summaries are just one to two paragraphs. Write the executive summary after you have completed the report and have decided your recommendation. So you will write the summary only after completing the report. Just before that, don't write. Review your report and identify the key points, and use these to organize a draft of your summary. Make the summary concise, but be sure to show how you have arrived at your conclusion. Don't introduce any new information in your report. Executive summary should not communicate immediately from your report. You have to just write your summary. Okay. Then the next comes the body part, that is the introduction. Introduction, it consists of the everything is like whatever is there in body, that is introduction, description, conclusion and recommendation. It will be completely based on elaborate. I mean, you have to just write the elaborate version. I just give me 1 minute at this time.
Thank you.
Okay. So whatever you write in elaborate form. That is, it should briefly describe the context and background of the research. What made you write this report? Why are you writing? What is the basic objective? All these things you will mention. Describe the change, problem, or issue to be reported on. Okay, so now say for example you're writing on global warming. So how it has become an issue that you will write. Define the specific objectives. Indicate overall answer to the problem explored in the report. Outline the report's scope, also known as its terms or terms of reference. Then preview the report structure. Comment on the limitations of the report. Then discussion or the description. It is the main body, and you will explain the conclusion. Means whatever is there in the table of contents, you will try to explain them to justify the recommendations also. Then key features to remember, present the analysis in a logical and systematic way. If necessary, divide the material with appropriate headings to improve the reader's understanding. Back your claims with evidence, explain your findings, link theory and practical issues, persuade readers of the validity of your stance. I'll just show you an example how it will be written. Then conclusion. Conclusion should be arranged so as the major conclusions comes first. Identify major issues relating to the case and give your interpretation of them. Relate specifically to the objectives of the report as set out in the introduction. Follow logically from the facts in the discussion. Be clear cut and specific. Be brief. Means whatever you what the inferences that you draw after writing the report will all be present in the conclusion. Then the last one is recommendation. Recommendation means it should be based on future plan of action. It should be action oriented. It should be feasible. It should be logically related to the discussion and conclusion numbered and arranged in order of importance. So this is very, very important. So what is the future course of action? As I said that how to avoid the fire. So the points that you will write, they all will come under recommendation. Okay, now what is an index? So index consists of the list. Okay, it consists of the list of all the names and important words that are present in the report along with the page number. So I'm writing this and I'll share this with you so that it will be easy for you. Consists of the list of important words and names that are present in the report along with its page number in alphabetical order. Okay, so this is an example of index. Then the next one is glossary. So now what is a glossary? Glossary is they are the technical words which are explained in the text. Okay, which are explained that are present in the text. Okay, so it consists of technical words along with their meanings and explanation that are present in the text. Okay, so this is the meaning of glossary. So for example, you are writing a topic on global warming, like for example, this one, what should I say? Suppose the word that you have mentioned is environment. Okay, environment is a word which needs to be explained. So it will be explained. So that is an example of glossary. Then references, acknowledgement of sources whose assistance you have taken while writing the report. So like, for example, you have taken various help of various websites, because for writing a project of about 10 pages, 100 pages, you cannot write it by yourself. You will need help. So you will, if at all, you will write directly, copy and paste it, like many have done in your answer paper. It will be considered as a plagiarized version, and the person who has written originally the written this work, the person can drag you to court, okay, because you are taking away his or her work. So, but what you can do is you can acknowledge them that I have taken the help of this person, and there should be originality in the report. Obviously, based on background information, only new information will come. So you have to mention that this is the website from where I have taken help. Okay, so this is the meaning of references. Last one is in appendices. Appendices is it, including the appendices or any extra material such as tables, graphs to support your research, but don't relate directly to the discussion. As I said, that it is not related directly. Those materials which are not related directly. You are writing about environment pollution, and say, for example, you are giving a detailed description about the sound. Description about the sound. Okay, so I'm not talking about sound pollution. I'm talking about the sound, the frequencies, and the explanation of sound. So that could be an example of appendices. Okay, so these are, as I said, that. These are the components of the long report, and this completes your report writing. Next class, I will start with the grammar. Okay, so now if you have any doubt, you can ask me. But I think there are some messages for me in WhatsApp from your group students. Let me check. No. B2. Yes, tell me any doubt you have. Okay, now I'll just come to the presentation part and the skit part, because both of them are there in your language lab. Presentation is there in your assignment, and language lab skit is there in your language lab. So please be sure that those, you have already formed the groups. Okay, so please follow that group only for both these activities. I think most of you are ready with your presentations, and next one is skit. So what is a skit? Skit is a type of role play. So what you will do is you will not perform it in the class. You will make a video of your performance, and then we will play it in the class. Okay, so that is the basic objective, but then you have time for that. Now I'm in a hurry to complete your syllabus. Today I have completed this report, and I think you have already done the report writing. Let me just check your assignments. If you have completed, the next class will be the report writing memo you have done already.
Yes, ma'am. We made a memo.
Yeah, you made a memo. Yes. So now next one is document. There is only one topic before for your lab now, before the Viva. Two, sorry. One is skit, the other one is documentation, and the third one is Viva. And since you have your exams on February, I am planning to complete as soon as possible. Tomorrow I will take the documentation, and this, if we complete documentation this week, next week we will have the skit. Next week I will take the Viva. And after that, the theory classes, I will try to complete the theory classes also. Then we will complete the class assignments, and then presentations and other things. Let me know if you agree to this, or let me know whatever you want, whatever you have in your mind. This is my strategy. You can always be free to share yours.
So ma'am, when do we need to show the PPT?
PPT... I'm thinking that let me complete all the lab portions, because lab portions, I think I'll take one more class. Today will be documentation, after that Viva, then it is over. Then for skit and presentation, you can present anytime.
Okay, ma'am.
Is that okay with you, or you want me to continue with the presentations in between? next class. Tomorrow you have your lab, na? So you want that.
Ma'am, and when do we need to submit a non-verbal communication PPT? Sorry.
That that we will keep it as January 20. Will that be okay? You because
okay.
That is I will put it in your assignment. Okay. I'll upload this assignment name so that you can just you can upload it under that topic. Okay. And January 20 is the deadline. I'll just mention everything in the class, deadline and other things. But keep
excuse me, ma'am. I wasn't able to hear you. When will you take the Viva?
Viva is okay. Tomorrow is documentation. Next Thursday.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Done.
And ma'am, what particularly will have in Viva?
Okay, Viva will be the topics that will be that are already discussed in your lab, because we finish after documentation, we finish the lab assignments. All the topics, like for example, first I'll ask any two questions from I'll ask two questions to one student, and there will be a group of, say for example, first five roll numbers, they will come together. I will ask, first question is very much interesting, the profile question, that is, tell me something about yourself, tell me something about your hometown, tell me something about a memorable event in your life. So that will have 5 marks. And the rest 5 marks, like for example, give me one rule of subject verb agreement with example. What are the ways of referring future? Give me one way of referring future, or maybe how present continuous is used to denote future time. Give me one example. And then another would be what do you mean by skimming? What do you mean by scanning? Documentation also I can ask about the font size and other things that I will teach next class. I will teach. And from your report, what do you mean by a memo? What is a internal report? What is an external report? And then this letter, what is a complimentary closure? All these things. Listening and writing, what do you mean by listening? Give me one difference between listening and hearing. All this. Okay, Rahul has not been assigned in any group. Anish, kindly please allow him, add him.
Ma'am, one more thing, like regarding these groups, I would just request the members who have already formed the groups to at least ping me with their group name so that I can put Rahul in one of the groups, because I only have certain groups and there are only 25 to 30 students as of now, and our class strength is around 80.
Huh.
So I haven't got any input from the remaining 50 or 40 students. But unless I get that, I won't be able to put Rahul in a group.
Today, by evening, all of you, please send your group member's name along with your group number, 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever. So, in that, and so that Anish, so that it will be easy for him to put those students who are not in any group into some other group. Is that okay with you? I'll also write it in the WhatsApp group.
Thank you, ma'am. That would be a lot helpful.
Yeah, okay. When will you conduct the defaulters? I'll conduct. Don't worry. That will be the end of the thing. I will conduct. Don't worry. Okay. Okay, then. So let me take the attendance and we are going to. Okay, so since your class is at 12:20, I think it's 12:10. So they are asking me it's a future time. In that case, what else to be done? Okay, then I'll mark attendance to all in that case. It's same future time. Mm-hmm. It's not coming. Okay, otherwise, meanwhile, you can tell me if you have any query or something like that, then maybe we can discuss about it. What is your group like? Now you can tell me if anyone is not having any group. Anyone who doesn't have any group, just let me know. Who? Okay, Rahul is okay. We know about you. Anyone else? Okay. Which group is having less than 7 members? Any group which is there which has less than 7 members? Or maybe 7. Okay. So what do we do? Are we going to wait, or if you want, I can give attendance to all those who are, because we already have 72 students, and I think some are there, some are not there. Okay, let me do one thing. Let me take the name screenshot. Okay, just 2 more minutes you wait. I think 1 more minute. If it is not coming, then maybe I'll do that. Good. Very good, B1. Similarly, kindly, you can also write second group, third group in this way. Please write the names.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, please.
Ma'am, what should be the duration of presentation?
Presentation, let's make it 10 minutes.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay.
वेरिएबल फंक्शन का एक्सपेंशन में किसी का कुछ डाउट है? Taylor series expansion of function of two variables. पार्शियल डेरिवेटिव जिसको मालूम नहीं है वो नहीं कर पाएगा. दोज हु डोंट नो पार्शियल डिफरेंशिएशन दे कैन नॉट एक्सपांड. द एक्सपेंशन ऑफ एफ ऑफ एक्स वाई about AB is f of xy equal to f of AB plus x minus a del by del x of del f by del x at a b plus y minus b into del f by del y at a b plus 1/2 factorial x minus a whole square del square f by del x square at a b plus twice of x minus a into y minus b into del square f by del x del y at a b plus y minus b whole square del square f by del y square at a b ऐसे चलता है. तो हम तीन टर्म रखेंगे. ये एक्सपेंशन बहुत लंबा है तो तीन टर्म ही हम रखेंगे. तो अबाउट जीरो जीरो में क्या होगा? Who can say f of x y क्या होगा? F of zero zero plus x f x zero zero plus y f y zero zero plus 1/2 factorial x square f x x 0 0 plus 2 x y f x y 0 0 plus y square f y y 0 0 इससे कंटिन्यू करेगा.
मैक्लॉरिन सीरीज है.
मैक्लॉरिन सीरीज ही दादल. टेलर सीरीज अबाउट ऑरिजिन इज मैक्लॉरिन सीरीज. तो नेक्स्ट टर्म क्या हो सकता है? हु कैन से नेक्स्ट टर्म क्या हो सकता है? 1/3 फैक्टोरियल एक्स क्यू एफ ट्रिपल एक्स एट जीरो जीरो प्लस 3 एक्स स्क्वायर वाई एफ एक्स एक्स वाई एट जीरो जीरो plus 3xy square fxyy at 0, 0 plus yq f triple y at 0, 0. Little bit complicated, but not difficult. लिख लो. हो गया.
Yes, sir. Done.
एक लॉन्ग टाइम क्वेश्चन श्योर. एक्सपांड एफ ऑफ एक्स वाई इक्वल टू ई टू दी पावर एक्स टैन इनवर्स वाई about 1 1. तो मेरा पहला काम क्या है, देखो एफ ऑफ एक्स वाई है ई टू दी पावर एक्स टैन इनवर्स वाई, तो एफ 1 1 क्या होगा, ई टैन इनवर्स 1. टैन इनवर्स 1 का वैल्यू क्या है, पाई बाई 4. That is e pi by 4, the first derivative. First derivative fx, that is also e to the power x tan inverse y, fx 11 will be what? E tan inverse 1 dg e pi by 4. सेकेंड फर्स्ट डेरिवेटिव क्या है? e to the power x. यहाँ पर और प्रोसीजर मतलब डिफरेंशिएशन का प्रोसीजर हम अप्लाई नहीं करेंगे. डायरेक्ट यू हैव टू राइट एफ वाई वन वन विल बी व्हाट e by 2. देन सेकेंड डेरिवेटिव, सेकेंड डेरिवेटिव एफ एक्स एक्स यहाँ से आएगा. दैट इज ऑल्सो e to the power x tan इनवर्स y. E to the power x tan inverse y will be fxx 11 will be what? That is also e pi by 4. Fxy. Y ko with respect to x ya x ko with respect to y mein differentiate karo. That is e to the power x by 1 plus y square. That is fxy. 11 will be e by 2. Fyy will be what? Who can say? This is fy. Fyy will be what? Who can say?
Sir, 1 plus y square
minus 2y e to the power x by 1 plus y square whole square.
Y square whole square, yes.
Fyy at 11 will be what? Minus 2e by 4. That is minus e by 2. Up to second derivative, I will explain.
Hi. Nice. Sir, yahan par fxy pe ek baar dobara bata dijiyega. Ye kara kya yahan par apne? Fxy.
Fxy matlab del by del x of fy.
Okay, sir.
Election of e to the power x by 1 plus y square. Jo hota hai e to the power x by 1 plus y square.
Okay, sir. Got it.
So now, fxy ka expansion kya hai? Formula pehle likho. F A B plus X minus A F X at A B plus Y minus B F Y at A B plus 1 by 2 factorial X minus A whole square F X X A B plus 2 into x minus a into y minus b fxy a b plus y minus b whole square fyy a b plus dot. So about 1 kya hoga ye jis process mein likh raha hu उसी प्रोसेस में करना है. एफ वन वन प्लस एक्स माइनस वन एफ एक्स वन वन प्लस वाई माइनस वन एफ वाई वन वन प्लस वन बाई टू फैक्टोरियल एक्स माइनस वन होल स्क्वायर एफ एक्स वन वन plus 2xy, sorry, 2x minus 1 into y minus 1 fxy 11 plus y minus 1 whole square fyy 11 plus dot. ये वैल्यू एक एक करके हमें मिला है. एफ वन वन क्या मिला है? e pi by 4 आई थिंक e pi by 4 fx 11 fx 11 also e pi by 4 pi by 4 into x minus 1. Fy 11 kya mila? Fy 11 e by 2. E by 2 into y minus 1. Plus 1 by 2 factorial. Fx 11 kya mila hai? E pi by 4. E pi by 4 into x minus 1 whole square. So then fxy 11 kya mila? Fxy 11 e by 2. 2 into e by 2 x minus 1 into y minus 1. Minus e by 2 y minus 1 whole square. Plus delta. That I can write e by 4, I think, can be taken common, or otherwise you can leave here. कोई problem नहीं, कोई problem नहीं, यहाँ पर छोड़ सकते हो. Pi by 4 plus pi into x minus 1 plus e by 4 common गया, तो यहाँ पर क्या हो जाएगा? नहीं, यहाँ छोड़ दो. और कुछ करना जरूरत यहाँ ही छोड़ दो. कहाँ समझ नहीं पा रहे हो पूछो. कहाँ समझ नहीं पा रहे हो पूछो. ठीक से देखो उसके बाद लिखोगी. बार बार बोल रहा हूं, पार्शियल डिफरेंशिएशन मालूम नहीं, पार्शियल डिफरेंशिएशन मालूम नहीं तो नहीं कर पाओगे.
सर सबसे लास्ट लाइन में क्या लिखा है सर?
FYY इक्वल टू माइनस टू ई बाई फोर.
So next page.
सर डन
सबका हो गया
सर वेट नो सर Yes, sir. Done.
Done, sir. खुद ट्राई करो एक्सपांड एक्स स्क्वायर वाई प्लस थ्री वाई माइनस टू इन पावर्स ऑफ एक्स माइनस वन एंड वाई माइनस टू खुद ट्राई करो एक सिंपल क्वेश्चन मतलब कहां पर एक्सपांड करने के लिए दिया गया है
एट वन एंड टू
वन एंड टू ए का वैल्यू वन बी का वैल्यू टू करो करके बताओ एफ ऑफ एक्स वाई है एक्स स्क्वायर वाई प्लस थ्री वाई माइनस टू एफ ऑफ वन टू क्या होगा फटाफट बताओ
फोर
दैट इज फोर हाश डेरिवेटिव
अच्छा फर्स्ट डेरिवेटिव वाज 4 सर एफएक्स 1 2 वाज 4 आई कैलकुलेटेड दैट से
3 2 6 2 8 दैट इज 6
यस सर एफएक्स 1 2 वाज 4 यस
एफएक्स इज 2xy तो एफएक्स 1 2 विल बी व्हाट
4
4 x square plus 3
yes sir
y 1 2 will be what
that four. Is
x 4 sir
again 4
second derivative fxx 2y fxx 1 2 will be 4 fxy will be 2x fxy 1 2 will be 2 fyy that is 0 fyy 1 2 will be 0 so now formula likho main nahi likh raha hu तो सीरीज क्या होगा एफ वन टू प्लस एक्स माइनस वन एफ एक्स वन टू प्लस वाई माइनस टू एफ वाई वन टू प्लस वन बाई टू फैक्टोरियल एक्स माइनस वन होल स्क्वायर f x x 1 2 plus 2 y sub x minus 1 y minus 2 f x y 1 2 plus y minus 2 whole square f y y 1 2 ऐसे चलता रहेगा एक एक करके वैल्यू बताओ ये हुआ 6 You have 4 into x minus 1 into 4 into y minus 2 plus 1 by 2 factorial fxx 1 2 kya hua tha? 4. 4 2 0. 4 into x minus 1 whole square 2 into 2 4 x minus 1 into y minus 2 ये तो जीरो हुआ था जीरो इंटू वाई माइनस टू होल स्क्वायर इसे कर सकते हो या एनी डाउट
नहीं सर क्लियर
तो कोई भी फंक्शन है ऐसे एक्सपेंड हो जाएगा
यस सर
ये पेज हो गया
है पेज
Yes,
सर ये कहाँ तक लिखना पड़ेगा एग्जाम में
दो पावर टू तक ही बनाओ.
ओके
पावर टू तक ही बनाओ.
सर ये टॉपिक भी चैप्टर टू के पार्ट है, नया चैप्टर में रहेगा थर्ड चैप्टर से.
एक्स्ट्रा और एक बुक दिया गया है ना?
हाँ सर.
ऋचिक को छोड़ के उसी बुक का एक पार्ट है ये.
ओके
सर. मैक्सिमा मिनिमा है, लेकिन मैक्सिमा मिनिमा टाइम के हिसाब से किया जाएगा. आज वो डिसाइड होने वाला है मैक्सिमा मिनिमा पढ़ाया जाएगा या नहीं.
सर रिगार्डिंग द एंड सेम्स, एंड सेम्स के डेट वही रहेंगे या शिफ्ट होंगे?
वही वही है.
ओके सर.
मैं कुछ क्वेश्चन देता हूँ, एक खुद बनाओ. एफ ऑफ एक्स वाई इक्वल टू साइन एक्स वाई. एक्स कमा वाई नहीं, साइन एक्स इंटू वाई अबाउट वन पाई बाई टू. एफ ऑफ एक्स वाई इक्वल टू ई टू दी पावर ए एक्स साइन बी वाई अबाउट जीरो जीरो. एफ ऑफ एक्स वाई इक्वल टू ई टू दी पावर ए एक्स कॉस बी वाई अबाउट जीरो जीरो. चार पांच क्वेश्चन कर देने से ये हो जाएगा.
सर ये ए और बी अलग है ना फॉर्मूले से? ओके.
किसी का कुछ डाउट नहीं? ये जो एक्सपांशन बताया, एक्सपांशन में किसी का कुछ डाउट है? ओके चलो, तो नेक्स्ट क्लास में नया चैप्टर शुरू करेंगे. नया चैप्टर मतलब जो न्यूमेरिकल मेथड एक पिकार्ड इटरेशन बताया था उसका और दो मेथड, एक ये टेलर सीरीज मेथड और ऑयलर मेथड. तो कैलकुलेटर पास में रख के बैठना है नेक्स्ट क्लास में. कैलकुलेटर पास में रख के बैठना है.
ठीक है सर.
चलो आज के लिए इतना ही.
थैंक यू सर.
अटेंडेंस थैंक यू
सर.
हाँ मिलेगा सर.
थैंक यू सर.
थैंक यू सर.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.